Quick actions in the new Adobe Creative Cloud Express. Stick around. Hello everyone and welcome to my channel. My name is Claudio. So glad that you're here. If you are visiting for the first time, thank you for checking it out. If you're returning, thank you as well. Well, you may be wondering, Claudio, why aren't you talking about Adobe Spark? Well, Adobe Spark has now been rebranded to Adobe Creative Cloud Express. A lot of the same features are still there, but there are a ton of new ones. And today I'm going to be sharing with you quick actions, which I believe, I know you're going to love. So let's go ahead and check it out. Here I am at the home screen of Adobe Creative Cloud Express. And if you look at it, it looks very familiar to Adobe Spark with a whole new section, which I'm going to be talking about today. There's a ton of new features, but we won't have enough time. I'm going to cover this one today, which is quick actions. I've been looking forward to this for a long, long time. Super excited about this. I'm gonna go ahead and click right here with this view all so I can just show you all of them. You have quick actions for photos, quick action for videos, and then you have a way to modify files. And if you look underneath, it's powered by Acrobat, Adobe Premiere for videos, and then Photoshop for photos. So let's go ahead and start with these quick actions. And again, it's basically what it is a quick action. So if you want to resize the image, if you've been looking for something on how to resize it, well, you can do it right here. We're going to go ahead and browse, or you can drag and drop, which I think it's great. So let me go ahead and show you my files here. Let's go ahead and bring those up. We're going to just bring them off to the screen, resize them a little bit here. It's got some files here, so we're going to drag and drop to resize an image. So let's go ahead and choose this one right here. We're going to drop it in here, and you have the option to resize it for square, for Instagram, portrait. You can do landscape, which probably won't work for this picture. And then here, let's click that. You want to make sure the picture is of high quality. There is Facebook, then you have Twitter and all the other different social media sites. So you can resize it just for that. And all you need to do is click download and it downloads the image for you. And go ahead and close that up. And let's go ahead and take a look at our image here. Let me just bring it into view. There it is, the resized image, ready for Pinterest. So I'm gonna go ahead and jump over to the next one. We're gonna go through this fairly quick here. Now, remove background is what we've always had from before. We're gonna go ahead and for this one, I'll go ahead and just browse the file here. We're gonna go to our desktop and let's look for our photos. I picked one, I believe it's this one here. Perfect, I've got one where I've got my helmet on here and let Adobe Creative Cloud Express run its magic here. Mixing some art, there we go. Remove the background. What's neat about this is I can go ahead and download this right now. It'll be a PNG. And if I want to, I can click on customize and start a project. But since I just want to demo those quick actions, I'll kind of skip that for now. In fact, first, before we do that, let me show you the removed background. There it is. And there's the PNG. Let's go ahead and convert to a JPEG. We're going to take a picture and we're going to convert it to a, let's see, PNG to a JPEG. So let's go ahead, let's just use this one here again. We've got the PNG of this Christmas tree. I'll download it and basically I have a JPEG version of it. So I won't click on that just to show you. And then you could do the opposite, convert a JPEG to a PNG. So you're basically going the opposite direction. So here is a JPEG. Oh, here we go. We went to Roswell recently. We're going to convert this JPEG to a PNG and boom, now I have a PNG version of it. So really quick actions, just what it says. Those are the photo versions. So now let's go over to video. This, I'm super excited about these right here. We got trim video. So I'm going to go ahead and trim a video that I have on my computer here. So this one is one that I took while we went hiking. There it is. This one has me walking in this little trail. And what I want to do is trim it from the spot where I walk in. We're going to drag this to about there. And then we're going to move the timeline or buffer it up to about right there. So we'll go ahead and trim it down. So if I was able to trim this down, and there's the start time, end time, and I can also go ahead and do a little resizing here if I want to, fill the screen if I want. I'm gonna go ahead and go back to landscape, fill the screen. Whoop, not that one. I wanted this one here. There we go. And I can mute the audio so I can just create a video with no audio. And I'll click download. And there we let the magic happen behind the scenes and download it. Now to save me time, I'm going to go ahead and click right here with this video so I can just go ahead and click here without having to choose view all. Now I'll choose resize video. I'm going to drop a video in there and resize it. And let's go ahead and I'll do this one. It's got my daughter hiking here. And here we have the option to resize. Here you have the different platforms that you can choose from. Let's say I want to go TikTok. There it is, resize, which is actually already the same size. Let's do Facebook and let's go vertical. And I can do that right there, which is awesome. And scale the video. You can bring it up. Let's leave it about right there. And I can also adjust the ending here. And then click download. And now I have a resized video version of the vertical video that I shot on my phone. I'm gonna go ahead and show you that one just so you can see. There is the horizontal version of that video. I'm just gonna slide it through here so you can see, boom. There is the video. Pretty cool, I love that feature. Now let's move to merge. I am super pumped about this one. So this one will allow me to merge several clips together into one complete video. This is great because I don't have to use a video editing software to do it. I can just drop it in here and I've got four sequential videos here that I shot. I'm going to drop them in here. What's nice is I can also reorganize them or shuffle them so I can move them in different order here, but this is how I want them to show up. And what I'll do here, I can mute the audio for each clip or leave it on, and I can trim each clip if I want to. I'm gonna just leave them in their full versions there. So this clip, or I should say merged videos, is going to be about 21 seconds. And let's see, we got 1, 2, 3. Don't know why this one disappeared, but we'll go ahead and leave that. And I can resize it if I want, but I'm going to leave it merged as a 9x16. I'm going to go ahead and click download and I'll show you the final. All right, let's take a look at that final video. It is going to have audio, but I'm going to go ahead and mute it just a little bit. Let's bring it into view. Let's turn it off. And there is clip number one. Let me just move it along. There's the next one there. And then the next scene there. And I'll just kind of skip through here. So there I have four video clips merged together as one. I love this action here. Super pumped about that merged videos. All right, let's take a look at this one here. Convert a video to a GIF. Now I'm on the GIF side of things. I know some others say GIF, but for this video, we're going to use GIF. And let's go ahead and use the same one here. Daughter is walking on that log again. We're going to take that and convert it to a GIF. And so here you have the option to choose high quality. It's going to be large file, medium and small. And right here, you can also change the size. So I can go ahead and choose square. Let's go ahead and fill that. And I can go ahead and move that here. And I'm going to just adjust the end here a little bit. And we'll click download and that video is going to be converted to a GIF. So let's let the process happen and I'll show you the final version. Okay, let's take a look at the GIF. Let's move this. Oh, actually what I think I need to do is actually take my downloads folder, and it's a little messy here. I want to show you. I'm just going to show you. There it is right there. And again, it's medium quality because it's going to be shared on social media. Again, there's the title, it's a GIF. The audio is removed, so that is super, super awesome. convert it to GIF. All right, let's move on. We've got several more. Crop videos, basically what you're able to do is crop your video from any size you want. So let's go ahead and see here. I'm going to take one of these here. I think this one I'll use. We're gonna drop this one in here. And just like that, we can do a free form crop. I'm going to go ahead and mute this. You can do free form crop, or you can, I should say, I'm sorry, that was square. But if I want to do free form, you can pretty much do any size you want. But you got to make sure that it will fit wherever you intend to share it. So I'll go here to square and let's see, we'll play it and see how it looks. So I want to make sure that everything is in view, especially when my family's walking there. So what I may do is bring this down just a tad bit and let's go ahead and see how it looks like. That works for me. I'll hit download and I'll have a cropped version of this video. All right, let's go ahead and take a look to show you what the final product. Let's go ahead and resize that, show you in view here. Audio still there, but we'll go ahead and mute. And just like that, I've got a cropped version of that video. Sweet. All right. Now you've probably been kind of looking forward to several of these here. We're going to talk about changing speed to the videos. We're going to adjust the speed. I'm going to be using my walking video here. This is something that you normally would have to do in a tool like Rush or Premiere Pro. Now you can do it right here in Adobe Creative Cloud Express. Here are your options: super slow, slow, normal, fast. Let's go ahead and go super fast and let's mute it. And I'm going to just trim it a little bit here for the starting point. I'm right about there. And I think I'll just let it fade out here. So basically, here it is, super fast version. Let me show you normal. There's normal right there. Super fast. And if I wanted to, I can go super slow. I'm gonna click on super fast, download this, and that is the speed option here in Adobe Creative Cloud Express. All right, now we're going to take a look at convert to MP4. We can take a video file and convert it to an MP4. So here I have an MOV. We're gonna take this one here. I'm gonna use my daughter's again. This is an MOV. And in some instances, you need to use an MP4, an MOV won't work. This would be a great way to convert that MOV file. I'll go ahead and mute it. Basically, it's the same video file, but it's been converted to an MP4 instead of an MOV. Simple conversion process. And here is the video file. We'll go ahead and show you in the Finder. There it is. It's been converted to an MP4 from an MOV. Now let's go ahead and take a look at reverse video. This one is super awesome, just like the other ones. So we'll click here and now we can take a video and reverse its direction. So instead of going forward, you can go reverse. So if you've been wanting to do something like that, well, now you can. So let's go ahead and we're just gonna use the same ones here. Let's take this one of me walking out into the trail and we're going to reverse the video and make it come back. So if you ever want to do something where it's going forward and back, you can use this option here for this quick action. And here we have the options here to change the speed. We'll go from normal to super fast. I've got the video already muted. So if I hit play here, let's go ahead and move the marker back over here. Let's hit play and there I am coming in reverse. Really cool. Let's go ahead and pause that and we'll download that. And now we have the same video, but now in reverse. And those are the video quick actions. Now we're going to take a look at the PDF quick actions. Here we can convert a file to a PDF and then convert from a PDF. So let's go ahead and start with convert to PDF. And we're going to take a file here. So it says you can take a Microsoft Word, Excel, PowerPoint, or image and convert it to a PDF. So let me go ahead and take, I've got a Word document here. We're going to drag that here and let the magic happen. Create a PDF from that Word document. All right, here we have an 11-page Word document that's now been converted to a PDF. All I'll do here is click on download and let's see what it looks like. And here is the PDF version of that Word document. I'm gonna go ahead and click through so you can see. So all that content in that Word doc has been converted to a PDF. And lastly, we're going to take and convert from a PDF. So let's go ahead and click that. And here it says drag and drop the PDF to export as any of the following formats. So I can convert a PDF to a Excel document, PowerPoint, PNG, rich text, Word document, and so on. So let's go ahead and drag a PDF. And I have this one here. This is a top 5 photo tips. And it's going to take it now. There it is right here, just so you can see the PDF. And let's go ahead and convert that to, let's choose PowerPoint and download it. And now I can use this PDF as a PowerPoint. And here is my PowerPoint that was created from the PDF using the convert from PDF quick action, now available in Adobe Creative Cloud Express. I recommend you check out all the different quick actions, try them out, and see which one is your favorite. Let me know in the comments below. And that's a look at quick actions in the new Adobe Creative Cloud Express. Be on the lookout for more videos to new features available in Adobe Creative Cloud Express. If you have any comments or questions about this video or Adobe Creative Cloud Express, feel free to drop it in the comment section below. Don't forget, hit the like button, subscribe, click the bell to be notified for future videos, and please do share this video with others. Thank you for stopping by, and as always, be good to one another. Peace.